Some clubs keep it with E6 only, some clubs keep it. Ideally, it's referred that till P10, the mentor should be mentoring the person. And if interested, the mentee can continue taking the mentor. So that is the ideal time period. Yes, sir.
What is the best way to figure out whether a mentor or a mentee is doing this job to the best of his abilities?
To the best of his abilities?
Many a time it may happen that a mentor who has been assigned a mentee, he doesn't get the type of mentoring he desired. Right? So he didn't have a very good mentee-mentor relationship with his mentor, and now he is assigned to mentor another person. So he is in a dilemma, like what all he is doing, what he knows the best, and maybe there are other people to help him out. But what is the basic criteria to figure out if he's doing his job or her job to this office?
So first of all, it's not an examination. That person has to reach out to a particular level only that he will be qualified to be to a particular mentor. But when you are a mentee or you are a mentor, one of the foremost thing which you should be getting to is satisfaction. If your mentee is satisfied with what you're providing, and that includes your mentee's objectives. If the goals with which the mentee has come up with the Toastmasters are fulfilling, then of course you're fine. You're fine to go ahead. And similarly, if a mentor has those objectives with which he or she has taken up this job voluntarily, they are being met, then that's fine. So what is the best way? When you have a mentor being assigned to you, what you can do is in the very first way, have a meeting with your mentor. Like we all do in our corporate life, we organize a list of goals in the start of the year, and then we keep a check on those goals after a particular timeline, that have we achieved those goals or not. Similarly with the mentor meeting, draft a design of goals, sit with your mentor and draft a design with the both fronts, on the mentor front and the mentee front. And once you have completed 2 months or 3 months, dedicate a proper milestone on the timeline. And if you have achieved those goals, that's fine. And otherwise, you can tell your education, okay, I'm not being able to. First of all, you have a discussion with your mentor as well, and then you can have a escalate to the VP education that, okay, I'm not satisfied with what is going on. Perhaps I need more help. That's it. Anyone else?
What if the mentee is not very responsive, even if the mentor is talking about it and actually getting motivated, but you are not getting that same kind of response from the mentee? So how does the mentor then deal with such a situation?
So the best way to deal with a cold mentee. See, there may be people who have a very different scenario in the life, who may not be sure of speaking on the stage, who may not be very confident with the things. So you have to analyze the person, that what is the problem. Some people might not be confident, some people might not be willing, or some people might be dealing with their own personal problems. Perhaps the corporate life is not allowing them to come up regularly or being so active. So you have to understand the person first. You have to analyze what is going wrong with that person. You can sort it out. It's just like parent and child. When a child gets rough, what do the parents do? They try to analyze the child and they need to know what is going on. So that is what. Anyone else? We can take the last question for the day. Yes, sir.
It's just something related to this also, and also parents, as you have already mentioned, as a child or a mentee, both are the same, in my case. So if the mentee, I'm giving you an example of mentee, but if he or she is not accepting, suppose I'm asking him that you can do it, but as per the last experience is failure,